obviously a great way to end the season. How much of a difference does that make as you head into the off season now with a real good feel-good moment at the end of the year?
Well, I think, you know, winning on the road for Game 11 in St. Cloud is a huge boost to us, you know, in terms of momentum. I think, number one, it gives it's a great way for the seniors to go out. A big win, somewhat of an unexpected win, I would guess, from those on the outside. So that gives them some really good feelings. And for us, for the team returning, it gives us a great boost, not just to our returners in the off season, but then also for us as coaches as we get on the recruiting road.
Coach, can you say like an effort like that? You know, your team was there, but you know the play that you have defensively to get those two pick sixes. Once in a while, a player can take over a game. It seemed like that may have been a situation on Saturday.
Well, I think you know Keontae had a phenomenal game. I mean, you don't often see a guy get three picks in one game, let alone two of them pick sixes, and legitimately a third probably should have been a pick six. But he was definitely the difference maker for us. I mean, we struggled offensively to score touchdowns. Jose Luis Moreno has been phenomenal these last 2 weeks, kicking field goals where we knew we could rely on him to get us 3 points, especially from way out, which is a complete 180 from the first couple weeks of the season. You know, we had some guys come through and we needed it, and that's, you know, really kind of the definition of being a solid team, being able to pick each other up when we need it.
Moving into the offseason, is there a certain recruiting group, that position group that you might specialize in trying to have most of your focus in?
I wouldn't say there's any specific position that we're trying to focus on. I mean, we're focusing on all of them. You know, we're still in the process of, we need a huge, strong class recruiting this year, and we're thin at everything, so we need to really boost that at all positions. We lose 20 seniors, which is quite a big hit, especially when our junior class is so small. So I wouldn't say there's any one specific area, but we definitely have some major holes to fill.
I know your season just ended 2 days ago, but heading into the spring, do you have a set quarterback, or is it open competition?
It's definitely a wide open competition. There's nobody that's specifically a guy for that job right now. I thought Andy Jones had some opportunities to be that guy. But he didn't take those reins. I think Ben Belinsky's been really good as our number three, as he's starting to get more reps. We started to get him on the field in some different ways, just because we know how athletic he is. And then we still have two other quarterbacks that redshirted for us this year. So we've got a lot of guys there. We got a lot of youth, you know, guys that have a number of years ahead of them as well. So it'll be fun to see. And we're going to try to bring in the best quarterback we can in this recruiting class as well. So I think for us, we want to be competitive in everything we do, and so for us recruiting-wise, it's the same thing. We want to try to bring in the best guy we can at every position, and that's going to create the guys here having to be more competitive to keep their spots.
You say most of your positions are like that, wide-open competitions, especially you said your seniors leaving and your juniors not being very big class, that not every spot, but almost every spot is wide open right now.
Yeah, I would say everything is really wide open when you graduate 20 seniors. There's so many of them were starters for us at different spots, whether, you know, at linebacker we started two seniors, D-line three seniors, DB three seniors. I mean, there's eight guys right there that were senior starters on the defense. And then offensively we had three offensive linemen, a quarterback, a running back, a couple wide receivers. So, I mean, it'll be a complete changeover, you know, to those starting lineups that walk out on the field game one next year.
How about the three wins and then the four games that were so close? I mean, those go the right way. This team can be a 500 or better club. Do you feel this is a team that is ready to take that next step next year?
Well, I think the team achieved what I was hoping would happen. You know, we wanted to win the games that we should, and we wanted to be able to see if we could steal one. It took us till game 11 to do that, but we were close in a lot of other ones. I think this one was a pretty meaningful one to take, just because of the legitimacy of who St. Cloud State football is. But I think we've made the right steps going forward. I mean, we're nowhere near where we want to be in the long range of things. But I think as far as separating ourselves from where we were, I think we've taken a positive first step for sure.
What does winning against St. Cloud mean for your first off season of recruiting kids to Minot State?
Well, I think it means a lot in terms of as you look at who we're recruiting in the area that we recruit. We're heavy here in the Midwest with the Dakotas and Minnesota and Montana. And even up into southern Canada, I mean, all those places have a pretty good idea of who St. Cloud State is. They've heard of them. It's a Division I hockey program, so they get a lot of national publicity just as, in terms of name recognition. So to be able to take that win and have kids understand that that's a good football program, it gives us a lot of that immediate legitimacy that we're on the right track and see if we can get some of those kids to want to buy into what we're trying to build here.
Saturday, you said that the goal for your first year was never really about wins or losses, it was about being competitive. What's the goal for year two?
Well, I think for year two, it's to be able to continue the competitiveness. I think that'll always be a constant theme, but now our young guys will become old guys. Even if they're freshmen, they're going to have to be in leadership roles just because of the way our numbers are. And I think I'm not even looking so much at year two right now as much as I'm looking at our off season and who's gonna show up as a leader. You know, we've started to see a few of our young guys that we think are going to be phenomenal leaders for us, and now we got to see it happen in the weight room. We have so much size to build and doing all those things right and nothing that I was a part of before. You know, I got here February 1st, and really as you look at December and January, those are two crucial months for how we learn how to be tough, and you know, the word I like to say is grit, and that's just true toughness. And you can't tell somebody to be tough and then they're just tough. You gotta really train them that way and get them to work that way, and it all happens in the off season. So that's really what we're more looking forward to. And then once we get into spring ball, then I think I'll have a better opportunity to answer that question, you know, in a legitimate way.